men's 4x100 freestyle relay, always a highlight, and there's great expectation here because of just who's in the lineup and just what might be in store for us. The Americans for so long have dominated this event. Oh, look at the Russians, wow.
It's a great atmosphere in the marshalling area, final call room, waiting to come out for a relay, going to battle with your teammates. Here's South Africa.
Well, they won the gold medal famously in Athens in 2004, and Townsend and Schoeman were part of that team, gold medalists from 8 years ago. So here come the Germans. No change to the German lineup, by the way, from this morning. South Africans have got the same team, but they've changed the order. So the Germans, fourth in Sydney, eighth in Athens, didn't make the final 4 years ago. They're outsiders here.
Just shows the depth of the American team, where they put in a whole new team for the final.
Well, the Russians have made some changes too. They've got two new members here from the heat. They've got Morozov and Izatov to bring them home, and they've changed the order of Lobintsev. So a little fiddle there as well, but Izatov is in the final of the 200 free to anchor them.
First time we get to see Matt Target and Eamon Sullivan as they join the team for the final for Australia.
Here are the favourites, the Australian team, and the missile, James Magnusson now. Well, he
leads them off, so he gets an official time in the 100 freestyle as well. Matt Target will be second, Eamon Sullivan third, and James Roberts, who was a little bit slow this morning in the heats.
So here come the Americans.
Isn't that interesting? You look at them and it looks as though they're four individuals coming together as a team rather than as a team. Two of the athletes with headphones on. Nathan Adrian already with his goggles on. And Ryan Lochte in his own little space as well.
So Phelps and Lochte come into that team along with Jones and Adrian. Here's the French. Now they've dropped Bernard, who won the individual gold medal 4 years ago in Beijing.
And this was his only event here.
So Agnew comes in, the 200-meter champion, and Gillot comes in, so a different-looking team. Here's Belgium, no change for their team from the heat this morning.
Probably don't have the depth to be able to do it like the USA, France or Australia.
Yes, they will be outsiders here. It's a great effort to make the final. And the Italians, well, they're always around the mark. They're fourth in Beijing. They were fifth in Athens. They were fifth in Sydney. And Magnini has been part of a lot of those teams.
He's been around for a long time, has been a very successful 100 freestyler.
So where is the key here? I mean, Phelps, you just wonder what he has to offer after his swim. And what can the Americans do? But the Australians, I think, do start favourite.
Well, Phelps sits in at second. So if they had a lot of confidence in Phelps, they would have put him at the back for last. But the boys have spoken about, you know, you have to play to your strength. And the comment was that Ryan Lochte's got a pretty good hand going at the moment. So let's put him last.
There have been 10 4x100s. The Americans won the first seven. The Australians broke them in Sydney. And then the South Africans in Athens, and the Americans got it back over the French.
Oh, Magnusson is very focused, looks across, waiting for the referee to give the whistle, looking down the lane.
So, does he go for a world record here? He'll go for everything, I think, Magnusson.
He must.
So, the men's 4x100 final about to start. And the missile for Australia is in lane four. James Magnusson, Nathan Adrian of the United States in five. So from the top, Lowe, South Africa, Starke from Germany, Gresham of Russia, Magnusson, Australia, Adrian out fast from the United States, Laveau, France, Degenick of Belgium, and Dotto of Italy.
Adrian's time to win the US trials was a full second slower than James Magnusson. James is known for his closing speed over the second 50.
USA leads South Africa and Australia. The back end normally strong for Magnusson. Adrian has a little lead on him at the moment, and Italy going well.
So the Americans have a history of really rising to the occasion when it comes to relays. Look at Adrian.
He's holding Magnusson for the moment. This would be something. And Phelps about to go next. He's already got 14 gold medals. I think Adrian may just touch in front. That is a sensation. USA lead Australia and France.
And he's gone 0.2 of a second faster than he did at the US trials. 47.89 to Nathan Adrian.
So I just wonder here whether or not Phelps can hang on and hold off Target. So it's USA and Australia, and Russia's right up there as well. The Americans turned 13/100ths of a second in front of the Australians, and the French are close as well.
Phelps was brilliant underwater. That is the key to his success in the 100 freestyle. Australia is struggling to hold on to the USA.
So it's USA and France at the moment. Gillot having a great swim. Michael Phelps has had a magnificent swim here after the disappointments. Look at this. What a performance by him and Jones to go next. The Australians have got so much to do. It's USA, France, Australia. So Cullen Jones in the water, Eamon Sullivan for Australia, and it's Clément Lefeu for France.
And Russia is challenging Australia for that minor medal at the moment. Eamon Sullivan in the water, Cullen Jones, who is in fine form, a good 50 freestyler. He's also developed into a wonderful 100 freestyler. He's doing the job for the USA.
It's a big lead for America. They're 7/10 in front. Australia 1 second behind, and the Australians have got some work to do to get a medal at the moment. Now the French are close here. Lefeu is closing in on Jones, and also coming up is Sullivan. So the gap starting to close. There's not much between them, the Russians as well. So last to go for the Americans is this man. It's Ryan Lochte. Agnel goes for France, and Roberts goes for Australia. USA with a good lead. So much depending on the last 100 here.
Well, Roberts is sitting hard on the lane rope with Lochte. There's a little bit of a wave there for him to try and get a lift, but you cannot imagine that Australia can win or even take a silver medal. In fact, it's going to be France and USA battling this out.
Agnel coming at Lochte here. So here's the turn. Lochte leads by 3/10. Russia get up to third. Big last 50. Lochte and Phelps on the one team here. Agnel at the challenge. Remember, the Americans beat the French in Beijing in the most remarkable race.
Agnel's coming back.
He's got a big chance. Can France do it to America? I reckon they might. It'll be a touch. It's Lochte and Agnel, and the French are going to do it. What a race. What a swim. What a back 100 for Agnel. Can you believe that? Russia get third. A remarkable race.
What an amazing swim by Agnel. What an amazing performance by the French. Where they should have been in 2008, but they just got overwhelmed by the USA, by the moment. Ryan Lochte, who would have thought in the final stages that France would be able to come over Ryan Lochte? But Agnel, what a talent.
And I tell you what, a reality check for the Australian team as well. They finished fourth. It was the most wonderful race. I mean, the Americans did it to the French 4 years ago, and the French made a big move here. They got Bernard and they pushed him out of the team, and they brought two new ones in. The Americans, the four that came in, well, Phelps I thought was outstanding.
Phelps did an amazing job, and I think they needed to put him in there for a confidence boost for himself, but also to actually give some, he's a great 100 freestyler, to give that time to the USA that they needed. Cullen Jones also swam exceptionally well, but that team of Laveau, Gillot, Lefeu and Agnel, look at them. Oh, could you imagine the headlines in L'Équipe, the sports newspaper tomorrow?
Well, they've never won this event, obviously. I mean, only the Australians and the South Africans have won this event, besides the Americans. So 4 years in the waiting for France. And they were second at the World Championships in 2011, third in the World Championships in 2009, third in the Olympics in Beijing, third in the World Championships in 2007, and they've got the gold here in London. Well, Agnel, watch out in the 200.
Well, there's a lot of talk about Australia on paper being unbeatable, but anything can happen in sport and anything can happen at the Olympic Games.
A magnificent race with a stunning climax. France from the back beat the USA and Russia, and the Australians, who were favoured to win the gold, get fourth. South Africa fifth, and Germany, Italy, in Belgium. 309.93, 310.38, and 311.41. Gold, silver, and bronze.